Hi guys, welcome back. In France today, for round 10. It's going to be a wet race for a large portion of the time. I was just finishing the Avengers, that's why I took forever to load. It was unskippable credits.
Chat with Carl about the new parts, and we're happy that they've been integrated into the car. Okay, with any luck, you'll be able to feel the improvement. So give them a try.
It was a good game, worth playing. I don't know if I'm gonna bother with the multiplayer stuff, but yeah, it goes.
To activate your DRS in the DRS zone as well.
This engine's looking a bit shabby, but it's just our practice one, so I have it switched out. Soon enough. Struggling to get it in some of the. Everyone had a good weekend. Labor Day here in the States. I didn't actually go out. Way too hot. California. Rouge. Oh, what that one? No. Just pressing all the wrong buttons. We may need another session. Burn a bit of time in that.
Okay, we don't need to be far away from some rain. I'll keep you updated as the conditions change.
That'd be interesting.
Lock Watch the conditions. We think there's rain coming pretty soon.
Easy, even if we had to wiggle our way for a bit of traffic. Try and get this one in.
Testing fuel management here, so try to lift and coast going into the corners. Don't be too aggressive on the power, but remember, you still have to beat the minimum lap time.
Starting to get slick out there. Why did I hit the brake? I would have done it. Jimmy it a bit. What for? What did I hit?
Car repairs have set us back a little.
Really into the interperiod now. We got the fuel and the tyre bit out of the way, which normally is the not the nicest one to do in the wet. Obviously the first proper track that we've had three races now. You get Monaco, Azerbaijan and Canada back. For want of a better term, they're street tracks. Canada's less so, but... Obviously all very different, but... It's nice to have a bit of runoff again. I see you still got a little way to go before it pops. So it doesn't really matter, we're gonna run it into the ground. Well,
give us a consistent second laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into the race strategy.
That's an enjoyable Italian Grand Prix yesterday. Danny Kvyat got his first ever win. Kind of felt bad for Carlos Sainz, but also Alex Albon. Really not the day he would have wanted. In terms of the championship, I don't think it'll make any difference. It was at least fun to see Lewis have to do some work. Cut out reason. Edit. Find it. Twice that's happened. Remember when it's wet, to avoid the really low gears, that's where I'll get the wheel spin.
Great lap, you've nailed what we asked for, keep it up.
Brain appears to have stopped first, so we might be able to get the qualifying done. Set us off. Let's see if we're going to get. Even when the sun comes out, that'll make the. Projecting that it's coming towards the end of the race. Maybe try and one stop and really extend the life of a set of inters, or will we do two really short inter stints, really push them. Oversteer, I was expecting. It's not actually that bad. Pretty controllable.
Okay, job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused.
low gear oversteer that happened, especially in the wet. Survived the one half of a lap, pretty dry track. Should be alright, even with that hole. And get this qualifying done. Move on. It's actually probably not a bad way it worked out for us. We did the race session in the wet, probably in the dry. Pretty much what we're expecting.
Okay, this is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat.
Track's still green, so just be careful with that. Well up on the time, so that's good. Use this Ferrari as a bit of forward momentum. Next bit's particularly easy to get past, but we'll have a go. But we managed it.
Okay, test completed.
Okay. Pretty sure.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Thomas, Hamilton.
Weather reports time. And soon, two more races. Yeah, durability's not been bad. Nothing like last year. I was killing parts, especially gearbox. McLaren have a bit of a gap. No one really behind it. Have a nice clean bit of track. In our practice quality, I was turning in too late. Now I'm turning in too early. Taking too much curve on the inside. Good start. Oh no, really quick overall. There it is. Okay. Lando's not particularly fast this time around, but you should find it. Thing I have noticed, teams are much more spread out and qualifying than they are this year in 2020. Take out Mercedes, obviously. So we're just going to run the softs here. No need to burn a medium. Well, in hindsight, I don't know if that would leave me. Soft for the race, though. Shouldn't affect us too much, but. Something I should have thought about. Missed the first corner turning, but got away with it. Why I decided to follow this racing point, I don't know. Stop you. Two. Yeah, so in terms of size, I've got one. Alright, so I do have a soft brace of 1 minute. All that shape for two. Five. Not the best first sector. Gonna have to be in the 128. To have a sniff at pole. Pass this through sector two though, but that's without a Mercedes running. Quite put the power down as big tank slap out of there. Lando got a great time. 128.9. Got on the 128. A good lap. But what will be, will be.
Tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Thomas, Hamilton, and...
So it's two Mercedes being sandwiched by us.
Fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. Great qualifying session. Are you feeling safer ahead of the pack? It's got to be a relief to qualify that far up the grid.
Oh, I'm getting a lot of love.
This team at the moment. What are your thoughts on them? Appreciate your time.
That's a dumb fuck all. What are you on about, love?
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Still no change in the weather report.
Hello and welcome. It's time to...
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
We'll run the wet, then we'll switch to winters. Maybe soft to finish.
Mm-hmm.
Montana will spin off the line. Well, I couldn't see Bottas. He still hit me. Where Lando is, he must have had a penalty. He is down behind Sainz. Sick. Unless he just got a really bad start like I did. Nice through the chicane. Can't really see much though. Be good if we hit Hamilton early. Really wide through there. Wide again. In a bit of starting line right now. Gentle on the power there. Try and take Hamilton. Okay. That oversteer. It's kind of shot away from us now. Nice. Getting around the outside. Done it.
It's going to be getting much lighter over the next 10 to 15 minutes. There should be more grip, but don't expect a dry track.
Now it's just wait until the inters can come in. Nor Morris not being able to do anything on Back to Science yet. Building up a healthy lead right now. Fuel in the bank.
A new strategy is available on the MFT.
That's you telling me I should put in kill ya.
Okay, copy that.
Yeah, I was all past the pits. So everyone else is gonna dive in now. Apparently Lando. Very loose there.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed?
Lando's coming now. I can struggle a little longer. Have more of a gap. AI doesn't like the idea of double sacking, even with a 14-second lead. Very loose again.
It's borderline, but if I were you, I'd come in and change tyres. I'm just not sure we're on the right ones for the conditions anymore.
How's that, bud?
Let's box this lap.
It's just telling me the
Lando
obvious.
In the pits. Lando in the pits.
For some reason Bottas disappeared. Now.
Confirmed.
What was going to do anyway? Yeah, I think Bottas had some wing damage after his. That's all of us. Smart. Well down the order during those pits. But they also did double stack. We're still comfortable in relation to Hamilton.
Okay, you only have to to stop once now.
Oh, it's going to be side by side. Lewis, the fastest lap. Oh, he tucked back in behind me. Track obviously of old.
Keep it up. We're looking at about 10 more minutes of rain. 10 minutes.
Stretch these tires till it dries. Why am I in new softs? I had a spare set. I checked. Ugh.
Let's use overtake and burn some of this energy.
Wide through.
Seconds a lap.
Not because I just had a pit.
Some information on Russell. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car.
Lewis Hamilton back again.
Okay, the gap behind is 2.2 seconds.
M10's got a name, I just can't remember it. Been enjoying it much in the wet.
Okay, clear. Back. 10 minutes left of this rain, then we think it's going to dry up. 10 minutes. The rain is getting lighter now, but it's going to take a while for the track to dry out. Inters look like the best tire for now.
I want to touch and not do what I think the AI will do is if they run out of their inters, especially because they pitted a couple of laps earlier, they may take a second set of inters and then a second set and set of dry tyres after that. I don't like forward planning at all. Gap's back up 5 seconds. Good.
We're leading our teammate by 40.
Teammate from last year. Mm-hmm. faster and faster with that. Tires are in good shape, actually. And they're still stuck behind Science.
The track is drying, but it's going to take a while to...
Opening of DRS is the signal. Go on, it dries. Also not see any water on the halo. Both the things still happening, so.
Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap.
Bank the mediums in case we come in a little earlier.
Check your MFD for a new...
into their mind about the strategy option.
Okay, I think the track will be drying out quite soon. Mind you don't burn out your tires.
Yeah, so the race is quite heavily spread out at the moment. Got 11 seconds on Hamilton, he's got 8 seconds on Sainz and Norris. We're then 6 seconds up for Ricciardo's, being followed by what looks like Verstappen by about 2 seconds.
Use your overtake button more, it's time to utilise some of this energy.
The whole field's a little bit... Anything to do with you burning it off, drain it for a few laps. think the next round's Hungary. That's round 11. Don't really need because of that. Almost caught it.
A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy.
Oh, look at you. Predicting that by Lewis. Rain's still there on the halo. It's discharging, it's not doing much. That 20 may be a push. Halo's definitely dry. Now we're just waiting for the DRS. And I'm struggling to find a way past Carlos. Hopefully when DRS does kick in, give him what he needs to find a clear him. Hamilton's boxing for his slicks. And those in.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Pitting this lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap.
or medium. Where?
Go now.
I'm gonna clear quite comfortably here.
Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
Immediately these feel good. Rocket ship will examine. Fastest laps going all over the field, and that's on outlaps. Is how much faster these subs are. Two seconds up. Our fastest time through the middle sector. Come on, Lando, you're right on his tail now.
Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap. We're expecting rain in around 10 to 15 minutes.
That won't matter. So apart from our early couple of laps fight with the McLarens, it's more been a fight with my engineers, Grace.
We're going to box this lap. Push hard on the inner lap.
They want to do weird shit like that. I box with four laps to go.
There's five laps of fuel remaining.
There's two cars in the pits. What have you been doing in the pit?
No need to worry about tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good.
Why are you telling me to come in? Lando's in a comfortable position now. A little bit of a gap on Sainz. He won't catch Hamilton. Possibly could have made more of a race of it. Not being for the bad start, whether that was a rip penalty or bogged down like us.
We're leading our teammate by 34.2 seconds.
Wait, kind of pulled us out there. Mm-hmm. Falcons are pretty much okay, apart from maybe the ICE. Saying that, well, drivers wise it probably isn't an issue about our engines. We're going to be about 2 or 3 races short with them.
There's only 1 lap of fuel remaining.
In terms of the constructors, really need to maximise our points all the way through to the end. Another good result for us with Bottas nowhere in the field really, he's down behind Ocon. We are cutting into that lead of theirs. We're expecting engine penalties towards the end. We're going to need a buffer. Another win for us.
Nice work, that's P1. Race win, well done.
Looks like Albon got overtaken on the final lap by Ricciardo there.
Of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Thomas increases their championship lead. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Well, you can't fault anything that Sergio Perez did out on the track today. He drove flawlessly, making him an easy pick.
Let's move on to the constructors. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
Right, so we're right up close with Mercedes now. Definitely a two-horse race between us probably for the constructors. Ferrari are really off the pace now. In terms of the drivers and those pulling himself back in, but still quite a way away from his slow start. Don't really know what happened to Albon at the end. He was in fifth, entering that last lap. He ended up down in eighth. Bottas only getting a point. What really killed Mercedes today? It's basically, my fastest lap got cancelled out by him. Another good haul for us.
Great work out there today. Let's have your thoughts. Do you think your rival learned from his battle with you? It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? How do you feel the weather affected the outcome today? Your teammate had a great race today.
Lando's been doing a really nice job for us. Beating Hamilton. Pushing on now for that level 20. McLean.
Morning, boss. Yes. This week's income from the sponsors has cleared. and we're making good profit against our running costs.
That won't probably last. Probably at the end of the year. Parts looking okay. Gearbox should be fine. Averaging about 10 a race, same as the last one. Good. R&D. We've got a crap ton of points. Nice big in. He's a bit of a wait on our capacity. Hopefully those come soon. We're waiting on our contract renegotiation before we do our marketing department. Oh, it's Austria. Hungry playoff. After round 11, I will start doing some more switches. I think that's where we've got to re-sign Lando. Maybe for our home race, we will have three massive upgrades. Really kick us forwards. Pretty much done for what we can do this year on powertrain. Quite fit on our aero. I'm less worried about durability now because they're meeting what we need. We down the line. We won't concentrate on them for a bit. Basically neck and neck between the two of us now. Right, so Austria next, be the next time we're on. One in tomorrow. I'll work those, but until then, see you later. Bye now.